Yes, recording is on now. So, hydraulic pumps. This is our today topic, and this is the last topic for third unit. So, we have to know what is hydraulic pump. Hydraulic pump is nothing but it is a device by which we can convert the mechanical energy to hydraulic energy. Like hydraulic turbine, what does hydraulic turbine do? Hydraulic turbine is convert hydraulic energy to mechanical energy. Vice versa, hydraulic pump convert the mechanical energy into the hydraulic energy. Okay, so see here what happened. There is one side water supply is there and other side water discharge is there. So what happened? See, this is our suction, means water is sucked by this portion, means we can say that this is the inlet and this is discharge. So what is that? This is our outlet of the water. So this is an example of reciprocating pump. Why? The water supply or water discharge is based on this reciprocating motion. So that this is our reciprocating type pump, and this is our rotatory pump. So because the due to the rotatory action, we get the displacement or we get the water discharge. Okay, so let us start. What is the definition? See, what is the definition? Water pump or hydraulic pump are device designed to convert mechanical energy to the hydraulic energy. Mechanical energy to the hydraulic energy. Okay, they are used to move water from lower point to higher point. Okay, because from the higher point to lower point, water flow naturally due to the gravitational force. Okay, but when we want to supply the water from lower point to upper point, means lower point to higher point, then we need hydraulic pump. Okay, because higher to lower is natural flow. We don't need any type of hydraulic pump there. But when we need to supply the water from lower point to higher point, means we have to supply the water from ground to top floor of the terrace. So we need water pump or hydraulic pump. Okay. So this chapter will deal with the basic hydraulic concept of water or hydraulic pump. So there are the pump classification. Turbohydraulic kinetic pump. Turbohydraulic kinetic pump, the first type. And second is positive displacement pump. Positive displacement pump. So in the first, turbohydraulic, or we can say that kinetic pump, there is centrifugal pump, radial flow pump, also called the radial flow pump, propeller pump, axial flow pump, and jet pump, mixed flow pump. But in our syllabus, only centrifugal pump is there. These two is not in our syllabus. Okay. In पॉजिटिव डिस्प्लेसमेंट पंप, स्क्रू पंप एंड रेसिप्रोकेटिंग पंप. सो स्क्रू पंप इज नथिंग बट दैट इज अवर रोटेटरी पंप विच इज ऑल इन आवर सिलेबस एंड रेसिप्रोकेटिंग ऑल्सो इन आवर सिलेबस. Reciprocating in also in our syllabus. Okay, so let us start. Now this classification is based on the way by which the water leaks to the rotatory part of the pump. In radial flow, what is the radial flow? In the radial flow pump, the water is leaked to the impeller in radial direction, in radial direction. Okay, that is this is our radial direction. Axial direction, so while in the axial flow pump, the water is leave the propeller in the axial direction. This is our axial direction. So when the water leave the propeller not in the axial direction, not radial direction, it is inclined direction, so that is our mixed flow pump. Means this is our radial, this is our axial, and this is our mixed flow. Radial, this is our radial, this is our axial, and the bottom one, this is our mixed flow. Now see the discharge. Systematic diagram of basic element of centrifugal pump. This is our centrifugal pump. What happened here? See, this is the inflow, means this is our side view. Okay, in drawing, in engineering drawing, engineering graphics, you study about the front view and the top view and side view. So this is our front view and this is our side view. Okay, so what happened? Water is insert here. Water is insert here, means like this, and above there is a discharge. In above there is discharge, so water is insert to the pump in horizontal direction and water supply in vertical direction. See, in this, and water is supply is horizontal direction. So here what happens? See, water is insert from here, water is insert from here and supply from here, which discharge from here and insert from here. Okay, so that is the intake, this is our intake, and this is our outtake of the water. Okay, now see, this is the discharge and this is our rotatory shaft. Systematic diagram of axial flow. This is our axial flow. So what happened? Water is insert in vertical direction. Water is insert in vertical direction and discharge in horizontal direction. But what happened in the radial flow? Water is insert in horizontal direction and discharge in vertical direction. But in axial flow, what happened? Water is insert in vertical direction and discharge in horizontal direction. Okay, now what is the screw pump? See, this is the screw pump. What happened in the screw pump? In the screw pump, water is discharged in the inclined motion. And what happened? This is the river and this is the canal. So we had to supply the water from river to canal. Then what happened? this is our rotatory motion, this is our rotatory motion like this. So what happened? By the rotating, this water is in between this screw, in between these screw, and the water is carried from between space. There are the space. In these space, water is carried from lower point to upper point, from lower point to upper point like this. So what happened? This is the distance where the water is there. So what happened? From these space, water is flow one place to an other place. That is our screw pump. Means screw is used for the water supply. In the screw pump, a revolving shaft is fitted to the blades, rotate in inclined throw and push the water pump through the out. So, like this. Okay. So, take an example of nut and bolt. हम नट एंड बोल्ट में क्या करते हैं, वी गिव द रोटरी मोशन ऑफ द बोल्ट. सो बोल्ट क्या होता है, बोल्ट को हम रोटरी मोशन देते हैं तो वो नट्स के अंदर लीनियर मोशन करता है. ठीक है, सिमिलरली या तो वो नट के थ्रू आगे जाएगा या पीछे आएगा, द मोशन इज बैकवर्ड और फॉरवर्ड. सिमिलरली the screw is there, screw is rotated, then what happened? Water is go forward direction and collect on the canal from the river. Okay? So next, see here. Here, what is that? This is the touch point. Means what happened? Water is there. Water is there. This is our river. And this is our canal. So what happened? Water is pushed out from the here to here. So what happened? This is our head. See? This is our head. So what happened here? Why we don't take H from here? Why this is not H? This is not H. This is H. Because in the inclined flow, we don't take the ground area. We just take the average area between the average line. So, see here. We measure the center point. And this is our capital D. Capital D, the diameter of the blade, including the blade, and small d, the shaft diameter where blade is fitted. Where blade is fitted. Okay. Now see the alternative device, which is gearbox and the belt drive. So, in the place of the screw, we can put the gear or belt drive. Okay. So, both are in the screw rotation. Now, reciprocating pump. So, what happened? In reciprocating pump, a piston suck the fluid into a cylinder and then push it up, causing the water to rise. Okay? So, क्या होता है कि one end से water को suck करता है and other end से water को flow करता है. So, the best example of the centrifugal pump is डॉक्टर injections. ठीक है ना, injection रहता है ना, तो injection में क्या करते हैं कि पहले needle को मेडिसिन की सीसी में इंसर्ट करते हैं देन वी शक द मेडिसिन, तो क्या होता है कि मेडिसिन को शक करते हैं तो मेडिसिन इंजेक्शन में आ जाता है, दैट इज द सक्शन प्रोसीजर, दैट इज द सक्शन प्रोसीजर। सो हमने क्या किया, वाटर को शक किया थ्रू द पिस्टन, देन फिर क्या हुआ कि हमने पिस्टन को पुश किया कि बॉडी में जैसे इंजेक्शन का नीडल इंसर्ट करते हैं देन हम क्या करते हैं पीछे से पिस्टन को पुश करते हैं तो जो भी मेडिसिन रहती है वो हमारे शरीर में चली जाती है, ठीक है ना। तो लेकिन इंजेक्शन में क्या है कि इंजेक्शन में हम एक ही तरफ से वाटर को शक करते हैं और उसी तरफ से हम वाटर को डिस्चार्ज करते हैं, लेकिन इसमें क्या होता है कि इसमें देखो ये सक्शन पोर्ट है, यहां पे हम क्या करते हैं कि सक्शन को शक करते हैं, वाटर को शक किया देन क्या करते हैं कि ये वन वे रहता है, ये क्या रहता है वन वे रहता है ना। तो मतलब क्या कहते हैं कि वाटर इधर से इंसर्ट तो हो सकता है लेकिन इधर से बाहर नहीं जा सकता, ओके इधर से बाहर नहीं जा सकता। तो क्या होता है कि ये देखिए यहां पे एक ऐसा टाइप का कवर रहता है कि वाटर इधर से इंसर्ट होता है तो ये कवर ओपन हो जाता है जस्ट लाइक दिस। तो वाटर क्या होता है कि यहां पे ये जो ढक्कन है ये ओपन हो जाता है, दिस कवर इज ओपन एंड वाटर इज एबल टू इंसर्ट दिस सिलेंडर, बट व्हेन द सिलेंडर इज पुश, जब सिलेंडर इधर से पुश होता है तो क्या होता है ये जो कवर रहता है ये क्लोज हो जाता है, तो वाटर इस डायरेक्शन से बाहर नहीं जा पाता और इस डायरेक्शन से हमारा डिस्चार्ज हो जाता है, ओके। एंड फॉर रोटेटिंग द पिस्टन वी हैव टू यूज कैम एंड फॉलोअर अरेंजमेंट, सी हियर हैंडल इज दिस। सो जब ये नीचे जाता है तो वाटर, व्हेन दिस हैंडल इज डाउनवर्ड वाटर इज इंसर्ट, व्हेन दिस हैंडल इज अपवर्ड वाटर इज डिस्चार्ज। सो ये रेसिप्रोकेटिंग मोशन आपका कंटिन्यू रहता है फॉर द रेसिप्रोकेटिंग पंप। नाउ व्हाई दिस डायग्राम इज हियर, ब्लीड बी गॉड द बेस्ट क्रिएटर, because our heart is also a pump, suction and discharge is there. So यहां पर देखिए from the body, so body का जो blood होता है वो यहां से insert करता है और इधर से insert करता है, ठीक है। और फिर ये जो three pumps हैं इनके through again body में supply होता है, blood क्या कर means क्या करता है हार्ट क्या करता है कि आपके बॉडी से ब्लड लेता है उसको प्योरीफाई करता है देन सप्लाई टू द बॉडी, कंटिन्यू वर्क रहता है हार्ट का। देन इट टेक फ्रॉम द लंग्स, ठीक है ये देखिए लंग्स से लिया, इधर लंग्स से लिया फ्रॉम द लंग्स एंड देन सप्लाई टू द लंग्स, देन लंग्स को सप्लाई कर दिया, ठीक है ना। मतलब बॉडी से ब्लड लेता है एंड बॉडी को सप्लाई करता है, ठीक है। देन सक्शन इज देयर, सक्शन इज देयर, ठीक है ना। बॉडी क्या हुआ, बॉडी से ब्लड को लिया एंड देन सप्लाई टू द बॉडी, देन टेक फ्रॉम द लंग्स, लंग्स से लिया देन सप्लाई टू द लंग्स। सो व्हाट हैपेंड, क्या होता है देखिए कि बॉडी से इंप्योरिटी वाला ब्लड लेता है हार्ट एंड उस हार्ट को लंग्स को सप्लाई कर देता है, और लंग्स का काम क्या रहता है, लंग्स का काम रहता है आपके वाटर को सॉरी ब्लड को प्योर करना, ठीक है ना, ब्लड प्योरीफाई करना। देन आपका ब्लड प्योरीफाई होने के बाद क्या होता है अगेन ये हार्ट में सप्लाई होता है फ्रॉम द लंग्स। अभी ब्लड को हमने जो प्योर ब्लड है वो हार्ट में सप्लाई हुआ, और ये प्योर ब्लड क्या होता है फिर बॉडी में सप्लाई हो जाता है, बॉडी से ब्लड को सच करता है, देन सप्लाई टू दी लंग्स, देन लंग्स प्योर दी ब्लड एंड अगेन सप्लाई टू दी हार्ट, एंड हार्ट अगेन सप्लाई दी प्योर ब्लड टू दी बॉडी। और ये काम कंटिन्यू रहता है, कंटिन्यू जब तक हम जिंदा रहते हैं, ठीक है ना। तो देखिए इसमें गॉड कितना बड़ा क्रिएचर है, कैसा मैकेनिज्म बॉडी में फिट किया हुआ है जिसको किसी भी तरीके का एक्सटर्नल पावर सोर्स की रिक्वायरमेंट नहीं रहती है। देयर इज नो पावर सोर्स टू ऑपरेट दिस पंप। ओके, ह्यूमन अगर लाइव है देन दिस पंप एक्शन इज कंटिन्यू। ओके, नेक्स्ट सी दिस सेंट्रीफ्यूगल। नाउ द सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप कन्वर्जन ऑफ एंगुलर मोमेंट, कन्वर्जन ऑफ काइनेटिक एनर्जी टू द पोटेंशियल एनर्जी, दिस इज द थ्योरी आर प्रिंसिपल बिहाइंड द सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप। पंप कंपोनेंट्स रोटेटरी एलिमेंट दैट इज इंपेलर एनक्लोज द रोटेटरी एलिमेंट एंड सील द प्रेशराइज्ड लिक्विड इनसाइड कास्टिंग आर होसिंग। ओके, सो सी व्हाट हैपेंड, सेक्शन आई मींस वाटर इज इंसर्ट फ्रॉम हियर, वाटर इज इंसर्ट फ्रॉम हियर, सी, सो वाटर इज इंसर्ट फ्रॉम हियर, सी, इधर से इंसर्ट हुआ देन फ्रॉम हियर इट इज डिस्चार्ज, दैट इज द वर्क ऑफ द सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप। सो दिस इज अवर इंपेलर, दिस इज अवर केसिंग, इंपेलर वेन्स, सी हियर दिस इज अवर इंपेलर वेन्स, सो फ्लो इज एक्सटेंडेड, we get the discharge from here, we get the discharge from here. Now see centrifugal pump radial flow are the most used pump for the hydraulic purpose. For this region their hydraulics will be studied into the following section: fluid in, fluid discharge. So same the diagram here. Now see the animation of the centrifugal. See the animation of the centrifugal pump. Okay. So what happened? There is the inside. See how water is insert, the actual axis is horizontal, this is horizontal, and where water is supply vertical, okay, so this is insert, this is supply, this is insert, this is supply, these are the insert port and this is to outlet port, and here a motor is here to rotate the impeller, motor is required to rotate the impeller. What can motor is do? Motor is do to convert the electrical energy into the mechanical energy. Motor is used to convert the electrical energy into the mechanical energy. And what is the pump? Pump is used to the convert mechanical energy into the hydraulic energy. So what happened? Mechanical energy generated from the electrical energy and electrical energy converted to the hydraulic energy. So there is two conversion, electrical to mechanical and mechanical to hydraulic energy. Okay? So motor is also there and pump is also there. So we see two energy conversion here. Now this is our actual diagram, our real diagram of the centrifugal pump. Discharge nozzle is there. This is casting. Suction nozzle is there. Means water is sucked by here. Seal casting, bearing, and seal flush line is here. Now, main part of the centrifugal pump, impeller, which is the rotatory part of the centrifugal pump. It consists of a series of backward curve vanes. The impeller is driven by a shaft which is connected to the electric motor. Means we have to need the motor here to rotate the impeller of the pump. Casing, which is an airtight passage surrounding to the impeller, designed to direct the liquid to the impeller and leave it away. See, volute casing, it is of a spiral type in which area of the flow is increased gradually. See, this is our casing and water is sucked from here and discharge from here. So this is HS and this is HD. Okay, and the total head is HD plus HS. Means ye kya hai, discharge head, discharge here means water को जो हम डिस्चार्ज कर रहे हैं वो कितनी ऊंचाई पे कर रहे हैं, दैट इज हेड. एंड वाटर सक्शन हेड मतलब ग्राउंड से हम कितना ऊपर वाटर को शक कर रहे हैं, दैट इज अवर सेक्शन सक्शन हेड. सो द टोटल हेड इज, द टोटल हेड इज एच इक्वल टू एच डी प्लस एच एस. सक्शन पाइप, delivery pipe, the shaft which is a bar by which the power is transmitted to the motor drive to the impeller. Okay, the driving motor which is responsible for rotating the shaft, it can be mounted directly on the pump or above it or adjusted to anywhere where is get the suitable space. Now what is the gear pump? See, gear pump. So it is also called a rotatory pump. See, this is inlet. So what happened? The rotation of the gear is like that. So what happened? Water is inlet is here. So the green is our suction water and red is our outlet water. So water stored between these gears. See here. And from here, water is forward to the outward direction. And see, this is our ideal gear and this is our driven gear. Means the motor is supply the motion on this gear and this gear is rotated by this driver gear. डिस्प्लेसमेंट पैरामीटर एंड डिटर्मिनेशन, डिस्प्लेसमेंट पैरामीटर एंड डिटर्मिनेशन. डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज पाई बाय 4 कैपिटल डी स्क्वायर आर सॉरी डी आउटर स्क्वायर माइनस डी इनर स्क्वायर टू एल इनटू एल. सो डी ओ आउटर डायमीटर ऑफ टू गियर एंड डी आई इनर डायमीटर ऑफ टू गियर मींस वी हैव टू यूज same size and shape gear in the gear. Actually, it is the diameter of circle defined by the center of the gear and the outer diameter of the other. Okay. So, train diagram is here. External gear advantage. Cheap means it is not costly, easy to manufacture, compact in size, so what is the disadvantage? The disadvantage is limited pressure capacity means we don't increase the pressure. Unbalanced, note where pressure is resulting in large bearing load. So in bear there is large load of the bearing. Can be noisy, means there is more noise comparison to other pump. Volumetric efficiency is low and there is fixed displacement, means we don't get higher height from this gear pump. Internal gear. So this is an internal, this is our head, this is our power plate. So that is mechanism. So yes, displacement is the function of number of teeth on the internal gear and external gear. Okay, and the size of the certain driver. So what is the formula for the displacement? What is the advantage? Similar to the external gear, whatever the advantage in the external gear pump, same advantage we get here, and plus point is quicker as gear slap is reduced. So it is quick response in comparison to the external gear. Somewhat more difficulty to manufacture. So difficulty is increased. Some issue to volumetric efficiency, means volumetric efficiency also low. Some issue of the unbalanced force. Okay. And same things is here, fixed displacement we get. See here, two gear is there. This is our inside gear and this is our outside gear. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So this is our mechanism. External or inside gear is shown as a driver. So this is our driver and this is our driven. Single tooth space is displayed. Design kept tolerance close throughout the cycle. So this is the full diagram of that. So the motor is connected to internal gear and outer gear is rotated according to the internal gear. So this is the getter and this is the internal gear. And here what happened? This is our inlet and this is our outlet. Now vane pumps. See the mechanism. This is inlet and this is our outlet. So there are vanes is there. So this is inside. So what happened? These vanes rotate like this. Water is inside and water is inside between two vanes and then it rotates this side and out to the outer side. So this is the rotation direction. So there is the water supply and here we can put this water to the outside. Displacement Vd equal to pi by 2 dc minus pr el. So what is this term? C is the fan, R is the rotor. So DC is cam diameter and DR is the rotor diameter. E is eccentricness. See, this internal gear not at the center. That is the principle of this vane gear. L is the depth. So we have to find out the displacement by the given principle. Now, vane tip pressure control option, outer pressure under the vanes, surface pressure under the vanes, intravenes, outlet pressure is applied always to a small area of the vanes, while surface pressure is applied to the rest of the area. These are the probable Wickler's invention and hence are cited in the text. See, balanced design. So what happens? See, red is the water which is supplied to out, and green is the inlet. See here, this is our inlet, the supply, and this is our outlet. So what happened here? Due to the eccentricness of the rotating part, the vanes is attached to the incoming water and supply to the outlet are discharged nozzle. So no need to this, we have to see this diagram. So this is our outlet, this is the cam ring, this is the cam where the cam is guide to the rotating part, and rotating part is eccentric so that we get more water discharge in comparison to the gear pump. Piston pump. So here, this is the inlet port and this is the outlet port. So what happened? Piston sub assembly is there. So there is a number of piston is attached. See, these two pistons here, these two piston work to suck the water, and these two piston are this portion is the piston pressure to water to outlet. So the in the piston pump, so there are number of piston where some piston is work as suction of the water and some piston is work as to push the water out from the cylinder. So this is the displacement of the piston pump. Yd equal to yad tan theta, y number of the pistons, okay, a area of a single piston, okay, d is the diameter of the center line circle of the piston bore, theta is the angle of Swiss plate or the bend angle. What are the bend is here? See, this is our anglement. This is the our Swiss plate. See, this is the vertical, and see the angle from the vertical to the Swiss plate is there. That is our theta. So this is our theta. So what we can do next? That is axial, that is our radial piston. So the theory is same, but this is radial in direction and that is axial in direction. So we just now the piston is attached in the bend, means inclined, at the incline. Now see, what is the advantage? Generally high volumetric efficiency, generally high pressure capacity is there, and variable displacement design is there. Okay, so in piston pump only we have three type of the piston assembly. First is axial, then radial, and then inclined. We fit the in this direction to piston assembly. What is the disadvantage? It is the so much costly. Cost is very higher. Now, how we select the pump? Fixed or variable displacement. So we can select the pump on the basis of fixed or variable displacement. Means we have to continue supply or we need to variable supply. Okay, so far our circuit is simple and we would like to use a fixed displacement pump. Later we look at more efficient circuit and may wish to select a variable displacement pump with the appropriate controls. So this is about our today lecture. Here our lecture is finished. So